Greetings from Delhi Medical Association and eMedi News. Welcome to our show, Chat with Dr. KK. Today we are going to have a chat with Dr. Suneeta Mittal, formerly Head of Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology at All India Institute of Medical Sciences and currently the Director at Fortis Memorial Research Institute at Gurgaon. Welcome to our show.
Thank you.
There is a concept of freezing fertility. To the extent somebody says that you can also father a child after death.
Yes.
That means even if you die, you can still father a child,
which
used to be a fiction story, but it's a reality
today. It's a reality today.
So what is this concept of freezing fertility?
The freezing fertility concept, of course, initially came with sperm freezing, that when sperm banks were being propagated, then the sperm had to be kept frozen and under quarantine before it could be used by someone. Then in the IVF program, whenever we are doing in vitro fertilization, we always have surplus embryos. So we were cryopreserving the surplus embryos for subsequent transfer. But now this freezing fertility has been extended, especially to those group of young men and women and even children who suffer from cancer anywhere, need to be given radiation therapy or chemotherapy, which can affect their subsequent fertility. We know that survival and lifestyle in these young is improving now with advances in cancer therapy. So they certainly need to be given an option that their fertility can be kept frozen, and once they recover from their disease, the same can be utilized, their gametes, either sperm or oocyte or embryo. There are various options. You can also freeze ovarian tissue in very young girls where you may not get the oocytes.
Let me give you a theoretical situation. A girl at the age of 24-25, either she loses her husband, she's not produced children, or she wants that I'm not going to get married during my life. Maybe at the age of 45-50 she decides to get married. Would it not have been appropriate for her at the age of 24-25 to have preserved her ova for this eventual possibility?
Absolutely, absolutely. In fact, this is not a hypothetical situation. Girls are more and more career oriented. So even when they are married, they are wanting to settle professionally and they are delaying fertility. And once they are delaying their childbearing, we know that after age of 35, fertility declines. So we also advise them that even if they are not ready to have a baby yet, they should get their embryos cryopreserved, because then their ovaries may not be able to produce enough eggs to give them a successful outcome. And of course, the scenario which you presented, that if marriage is delayed, then also their oocytes can be preserved.
What is the healthiest age for a healthiest sperm?
The healthiest for sperm, of course, you can get good sperms anywhere from 15 to even 65 years of age. That is not so much.
Is there an age for an ideal donor?
No. For the sperm donor, of course, ideal age is between 25 to 35 years.
25 to 35. Now, what about for ova?
For oocyte and for female fertility, the ideal age is between 18 to 25. We say that don't try and go beyond 30, because fertility will decline. And after 35, it certainly rapidly decreases.
Normally we say at the age of 35, if you get pregnant, chances of mongolism are higher.
Yes.
But if at the age of 35, you're using a ova which is 25 years
old, then it will not be there.
It will not be the problem.
And even chances of conception will be better.
And the chances of conception will be better.
Yeah.
If you would not have been a doctor, what you would have become?
If I would not have become a doctor, maybe I would have become a writer.
A writer? Do you write?
I write.
Fiction or what?
Both.
Have you written a book?
I have written almost 14 books.
Very good. And non-medical?
Non-medical, medical, both. And I also like to do a lot of public education.
Public education.
I think once they are aware of their health problems, they are more empowered and they can tackle their condition.
What about this gang rape? What are your comments about this?
It's something very tragic for our society.
If this case would have come to you, what message you could have given to the society?
I think the society, whether this case or no case, gets a message that women could and women have to be respected. They are not commodities to be used like this. I think men need to change their mindset.
Do you think that every victim and every road traffic accident, when the police reaches, must receive medical attention along with the police?
Absolutely.
So either the police should be trained or a paramedic should come with the police person.
In fact, I had conducted even some workshops. Then I launched emergency contraception. I was trying to train all police officers also.
Every victim should be given oral contraceptive, whether or not.
Every rape victim needs emergency contraception backup, needs sexually transmitted infection prophylaxis.
And do you feel that every rapist must be tested for sexually transmitted illnesses compulsorily?
If
HIV, hepatitis B, hepatitis. Today, consent is required.
Yes.
But it should be mandatory.
And actually, rapist should be punished first.
Oh, that's the difference. Punishment will take time.
But for the girl, we should always give her the prophylaxis for this.
So, what Dr. Suneeta Mittal has said is freezing fertility is a new concept. Every GP, every family physician should be aware of that. Let's thank our guests. Thank you to be in our show. And that's all for today. We'll come back with one more show. Till that, goodbye. Thank you.
Thank you.